Hi guys, I'm Eric Voss, and I think we can all agree that Doctor Strange was just pure ridiculous cumber fun. But a lot of you guys have been asking about the movie's ending, and yeah, the whole movie can be a bit of a mind f**k at times. But the ending is an especially aggressive mind f**k. Like, Doctor Strange, enough, my brain has to work in the morning. So in this video, I'm gonna explain exactly what went down in that final Dark Dimension sequence of the movie, and why it was so brilliant when he put it all together with a bunch of little clues that came up throughout the film. I'm also gonna explain why Wong revealing the Eye of Agamotto as an Infinity Stone is so important. And by the way, if you wanna know what happens in the post-credit scenes, I did another video that covers all of that. So this video is like a pre-credit scene breakdown. I know, it's crazy someone actually wants to talk about what happens before the credits of a Marvel movie. What world are we living in here? Okay, bear with me as I take a step back, but in order to understand Doctor Strange's ending, you have to accept that this entire movie is about time. And yeah, sure, it's about a lot of other things too. Broken position trying to heal himself so that he can heal and save others, letting go of pride and ego, mind over matter, hands. But above all, this is a story about a man struggling with time controlling his life, and that by freeing himself from time, he can use time to his advantage. So that basically, as the Beatles put it, time is a yellow submarine. Pretty sure that's how it goes. Throughout the film, this idea of time is represented in the recurring symbol of a clock. So like in the early scene, Doctor Strange is operating on a gunshot victim, racing against time to remove a bullet from his brain. And notice how when he tries to focus, he's distracted by the ticking of Dr. West's wristwatch. And then he snaps at him to cover it up to block the sound. Now, why does this ticking derail Strange like this? See, at this moment, Strange is at the peak of his pride. He's a brilliant surgeon, nailing this miraculous surgery that only he can do. And then best of all, he's rubbing it in the face of his rival. He feels invincible, but the ticking of the watch reminds him that he's not invincible. He's mortal. His own time is running out. Strange is kind of like a reverse Captain Hook. Like, he's driven mad by a ticking sound that will soon foreshadow a life-changing hand injury. Strange hates to be reminded how time is controlling his life. Another clock that keeps showing up throughout Doctor Strange is the watch given to him by Christine Palmer. And remember, that shatters when the muggers in Kathmandu try to steal it. Now, notice how that break happens right before he meets Carl Mordo and the Ancient One, and he begins his training in Kamar Taj. That's a symbolic moment of character growth for Strange. He's literally breaking time, diverging from his old timeline, which was trying to heal his hands and continue his life as a surgeon. And now he's going into this new timeline outside of time, breaking the laws of nature and learning the mystic arts. Okay, now fast forwarding a bit here, at the end of his training, Strange uses the Book of Cagliostro and the Eye of Agamotto to manipulate time, which is represented by this apple going back and forth between Eaten and uneaten. And when Wong and Mordo catch him in the act, Mordo warns Strange about paradoxes and time loops with this foreshadowing line: do you want to get stuck reliving the same moment over and over forever? And then Strange is like, huh, you don't say. That could be useful. Okay, fast forwarding again here. While battling Caecilius, Strange learns that the Dark Dimension is a place beyond time. Caecilius offers Strange what he thinks he wants: the freedom from mortality, to no longer worry about his time ticking away. Notice how Strange seems to consider this. Caecilius tries to drive the point home by saying, time enslaves us, time is an insult, death is an insult. But then later, Strange realizes the truth while talking with the Ancient One in the astral plane at the moment of her death. Her philosophy is the opposite of Caecilius. She says, death is what gives life meaning, to know your days are numbered, your time is short. So, finally arriving at the end here, in this final showdown in Hong Kong, Strange puts all of this knowledge about time together. He sees that the Sanctum has already fallen, and Caecilius has opened the gate to the Dark Dimension. Now, Strange knows that he can reverse time to save the city using spells and the Eye of Agamotto, but he knows that Caecilius is stronger than him and he probably can't beat him. So he remembers two things. One, the Dark Dimension is a realm where time does not exist. So by introducing time into it, that would give Strange a huge advantage. And then two, tampering with time can result in creating a loop, reliving the same moment over and over forever. So that's what happens when Strange floats up into the Dark Dimension. He creates a time loop, starting with him proposing the bargain to Dormammu and ending with his death. And because Dormammu has no understanding of time, he's trapped in this loop until Strange decides to stop it. So, just like in movies like Groundhog Day or Edge of Tomorrow, Doctor Strange dies and resets over and over. I personally counted 12 times, and he does this until Dormammu goes crazy, and Strange eventually breaks him and convinces him to leave this realm and take Caecilius and his followers with him. And what I love about this sequence is, just like Bill Murray in Groundhog Day and Tom Cruise in Edge of Tomorrow, it's implied that Doctor Strange could have died hundreds, thousands, maybe an infinite number of times. Notice how Strange invited death, regardless of how painful it would be, saying, pain is an old friend. And you gotta imagine that, like, Dormammu would have enjoyed finding new ways to kill him for at least the first couple hundred times until he got bored, and then maybe another thousand before it became, like, mildly annoying, and then thousands, infinite number of times more before it became legit torture. And it's really satisfying to see Dr. Strange show that he understands the Ancient One's words, that death is what gives life meaning. Literally, Dr. Strange's death, or rather his infinite number of deaths, saves all the lives on Earth, ultimately giving his life meaning once again. And then in these final moments, Wong of course reveals that the Eye of Agamotto is an Infinity Stone, specifically the Time Stone. And that makes sense given the godly level of power it gives Strange over time. So that makes 5 out of 6 Infinity Stones revealed in the MCU so far. And this officially ties Dr. Strange to the upcoming Avengers Infinity War movies, where Thanos will try to assemble all of these stones in his Infinity Gauntlet, basically making him ruler of all the universe. We're just gonna have to imagine how powerful Thanos is gonna become if he combines the power of the Tesseract and the Aether and the Mind Stone on Vision's head and the orb that Ronan used and now this Time Stone. Good luck, Avengers. But now let's talk about this final shot, which connects back to this idea of time. Strange puts back on his broken watch from Christine, and if you look closely, the way the glass is broken on the watch matches up with the lines in the Seal of Vishanti in the Sanctum window. Also, this watch wraps around the wrist just like the green time spell that we saw. So we're seeing that through this broken watch, that time is something that no longer enslaves Strange. Now, real quick, this video was brought to you by the great people at Warby Parker. They have a selection of really cool frames for your glasses. Now, if you ever catch me like squinting at the camera, it's because I wear contacts and they get super dried out from these hot lights, or you know, I run out and I have to wear glasses like that one humiliating time a couple videos back. Now, I wasn't a huge fan of those frames, and it's always hard to shop for new ones because the woman at the store is just like standing right there and she's like, those make you look cool, and they really don't. She just, you know, wants to make a sale, and then I fall in love with her and it gets super awkward. But Warby Parker is great because they offer a home try-on where they send you frames to try on for free on your own with your friends who will be like brutally honest with you. I love it. And since you, viewers, are my best friends, whether you like it or not, I need your help deciding which frames to get. So head to warbyparker.com/newrockstars to see my current favorite frames and get started with your free home try-on today. You can choose 5 frames that you'd like to try on, mail the frames back, choose your favorite pair or pairs to have your prescription added to, and then order. Warby Parker makes your experience completely risk-free. Visit warbyparker.com/newrockstars to begin your free home try-on experience today. And when you go to the site, comment on which frames that you like best for me, and you'll be entered to win a $50 gift card to Warby Parker. We'll choose it randomly, but you have to comment. I need your advice. I'm an indecisive idiot. Help me, New Rockstar subscribers. You're my only hope. All right, if you like this video, please hit like and subscribe to New Rockstars for more of these videos. And remember to check out my breakdown of the Doctor Strange post-credit scenes if you haven't already. You can also contribute to New Rockstars on Patreon. Big thanks to all of our current patrons. We love you guys. If you aren't currently contributing to us, you can start right now for as little as $1 a month. Every little bit helps in getting these videos out faster. So thank you guys again. Hit me up on Twitter at EAVoss with any thoughts you have on Doctor Strange or any cruel jokes you have about me needing glasses. You can also follow New Rockstars on Twitter at New Rockstars and bother them about when our videos are coming out. All right, thanks for watching. Bye.